Cromer is a small coastal town in the English county of Norfolk. The town's historical records go back to medieval times and show most people's living came from the sea and travelling to distant places. Many sea travellers came to grief on this section of the coast, as the nearest harbours of refuge were some distance away. There has been a lifeboat station in Cromer for over two centuries, which means Cromer had a lifeboat before the Royal National Lifeboat Institution existed. The end of the 18th century saw a national movement to provide lifeboats around the UK. A local dignitary, Lord Suffield, took an interest and led the way to starting a service in Norfolk, which resulted in the formation of a committee in Cromer to run a lifeboat station. In 1857, with the lifeboat organisation having financial trouble and the lifeboats falling into a bad state of repair, the Royal National Lifeboat Institution took over the Cromer station, along with other Norfolk stations. The RNLI placed its first lifeboat, costing £176, on service in Cromer in 1857. All lifeboats so far had been sailing or rowing boats. 1923 saw the introduction of a motor lifeboat to Cromer, the H.F. Bailey. A new lifeboat house and a 165-foot long slipway were constructed at the end of the pier to house the new motorised boat. Between 1923 and 1985, Cromer were given upgraded boats as they became more sophisticated in design and speed. The 1960s saw a new Oakley-class lifeboat at Cromer, which was one of the first self-righting motorised boats. A new boathouse and slipway on the pier were completed in 1998, with further adaptations in 2007 to accommodate today's Tamar-class lifeboat, Leicester. Cromer Lifeboat Station has operated an all-weather lifeboat and inshore lifeboat for the past 50 years. Cromer's volunteer crews have a record of gallantry going back to the beginnings of the RNLI, with rescues and service carried out by famous coxswains such as Henry Blogg and Henry Shrimp Davis and their crews.
My name is John Davis and I'm a lifeboat coxswain at Cromer Lifeboat Station. My responsibility is to look after the crew and get the boat away safely and rescue whoever needs to be rescued and get them back safely. The crew have changed quite a lot because in the early days, the majority of the crew were nearly all fishermen and they rowed and sailed for a living, so that was second nature to them. Nowadays, you know, there isn't the fisherman on the crew. I'm the only fisherman, full-time fisherman on the crew. And, you know, they can come from all walks of life, being butchers, bakers, thatchers, electricians, anything, but they have changed quite a lot. The RNLI has changed with them. They have their own college and they'll train people up to be, you know, very, very good lifeboatmen. You can see today we've got all modern, you know, equipment where years ago we had sou'westers and oilies and cork life jackets. Now we have you know, personal locating beakers and lights on life jackets and self-inflated and very, very good kit.
Cromer Lifeboat Station is probably best known for the service given by one of its coxswains, Henry Blogg, who was coxswain for 38 years, but a crew member for over 50 years. He was involved in many notable and remarkable rescues and received 3 gold and 4 silver medals, the George Cross, and the British Empire Medal.
My name's Paul Watling and I'm the station mechanic for Cromer Lifeboat. My responsibility is to maintain the all-weather Tamar lifeboat and also assist in all the maintenance in the station and also at the Isle of Wight. the maintenance on it has vastly improved and got a lot more. From the rail boats, there wasn't too much maintenance apart from paintwork and a bit of oars and stuff like that. To the early machinery type lifeboats, to now the high tech electronic stuff, which takes a great deal of maintenance. With the rail boats, no, there wouldn't have been a mechanic because there was no need for one. But the crew would have maintained the boat. On average, it's about 57 grand a year to run one of the all-weather lifeboats.
Cromer relies on its volunteer men and women who give their time freely to provide such an essential service to the townsfolk and others who sail our seas. There have been so many rescues over the past two centuries, and Cromer Lifeboat Station is proud to have been of service to the town. Thank you.